State management. Every once in a while, a new library or framework arises with another state management approach. Almost every application needs to manage data, and a state management framework helps to keep it organized. And there are vastly different approaches and patterns. To get an overview, we'll cover the most common state management patterns in Flutter and when they are recommended to use. And it is also recommended to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on any new video in this series. Let's see what state management is about, because it's not only a data storage. State management is a pattern or process in which the application data is maintained, and it can also manage input and output flows. So retrieving and storing the data is also part of it. In Flutter, the state is defined as whatever data you need in order to rebuild your UI at any moment in time. So what kind of different state management approaches are out there? So in general, there is a UI state and a shared state. The UI state, or ephemeral state, is the simplest state because it's only contained in a single view and cannot be shared between components. So at some point you want to share information between components, then you need to beef up the state management with a package like provider, blog, or river pod. That doesn't mean you don't want to use the UI state at all. In this series, we will cover the different approaches, starting off with the UI state, and then we take a look at shared approaches like provider and different packages. Let's have a closer look at the UI state. In stateful widgets, there is an internal state that can be updated using setState. And after calling the setState, the UI will be rendered again by running the build method. Just think of the current selected tab or a progress of an animation. Usually there is no need of other widgets to know the information of this state, so you don't need an app state or shared state for this. However, if you want to keep information between user sessions, like user preferences, notifications, or just think of a news app having a read or unread state, then you might want to use the app state to keep the data between the sessions. Otherwise, all the data is lost in the next session when you open up the app again. So this is not black and white, of course. There's no holy grail out there, but there are certain cases in which some patterns are better suited for. Sometimes you need to refactor an UI state into an app state or vice versa, but it is up to you if you want to use an UI state at all. As a rule of thumb, do whatever is less awkward. This was the first video of this series. Shared approaches like provider and river pod will follow. Thanks for watching, and if you made it so far, you may want to leave a comment what you think about state management. See you in the next one.